In this video, we practice using the properties of logarithms, and we do the following five problems. So try these two problems. Write each expression as a sum or difference of logs, and we're going to assume all variables represent positive numbers. All right, so what we have to start with number one is, well, this is a quotient, so I'm going to begin by doing subtraction. So that gives me log base 3 of the numerator, which is 2x, minus the log base 3 of the numerator, which is square root of 5. Now, let's write square root of 5 as 5 to the 1 half, because it's better to take anything in radical form and use exponential form. So that's what we have so far. Okay, second part. I have the log of 2x. Notice that's a product. So now I have to go ahead and rewrite the log of 2x base 3 as the sum of the logs of each of those that are in the product. All right, so I'm going to have to move this down, kind of get it out of the way for now, so I have room to do that. So that gives me the log base 3 of 2 plus the log base 3 of x. So what I've done is I have taken this part here and written it as log of 2 base 3 plus log of x base 3. Now that is using the product property. Let's go on to the next part. Minus the log of 5 to the 1 half base 3. I could take that exponent, put it out in front. That'll give me a minus 1 half log base 3 of 5. And that is as far as we're able to go. Now, if you didn't get that, write this problem again on a piece of paper. Don't look at this and see if you can get the answer on your own. All right, let's try the second one. So I've got the log base 2 of 5m cubed. All right, I do have something cubed, but the overriding thing is first I have a multiplication. 5 is not to the third power. That's really 5 to the first power. So it's 5 times m cubed. So the first thing I need to do is use the product property. So I have the log base 2 of 5 plus the log base 2 of m cubed. All right, can't do anything with this log of 5 base 2, so I'm going to leave that as log of 5 base 2. But now I could take this exponent from the m and put it out in front, and that gives me 3 log of m base 2, and that's the second one. All right, you ready for some more? All right, let's try this expression. This is going to be a little bit more involved. So try it on your own, see how you do by putting the video on pause. Okay, let's tackle it. So the first thing is I have a quotient. So again, I'm going to start off by writing it as a difference, right? The log of the numerator minus the log of the bottom, the denominator. So I have the log base 5 of 25 square roots of 7n minus the log of 5 m cubed. The trick in math is always breaking things up into smaller little pieces. Okay, now, let's look at this first log. I have a product. It's 25 times the square root of 7n. So we want to break that up into a sum, right? So we have the log base 5 of 25 plus the log base 5 of square root of 7n. Now remember, that's the same thing as 7n to the 1 half power. Okay, the trick is remembering anytime you're working with radical signs, you could rewrite the problem with exponents. And let's see, can I do anything over here? I have the log base 5 of m cubed. Well, at this point I could bring the 3 out to the front, right? I could use my product property. So that'll be 3 log minus 3 log base 5 of m. All right, can't do anything more with this. What about this stuff over here? Can we simplify this anymore? You should know this one. What's the log of 25 base 5? 5 to the what power actually equals 25? Did you get it? It's 2. Remember, logs are just exponents. That's why it's a small little number. Oops, now we got to deal with this. What do we do with this? 7n to the 1 half. Well, I could put the 1 half out in front. And then I have log base 5 of 7n. Now, you have to put a parentheses around the 7n. Actually, you don't have to, but it's a good idea. I better say it that way. Okay. Alrighty. Well, I can't simplify 2 any further, so I have 2. Now, what am I going to do with this? Ah, I got a product, 7 times n. So now I could break that up. So I have 1 half, and I could write that as a sum. The log base 5 of 7 plus the log base 5 of n minus this 3 log base 5 of m. And the last thing you might want to do is distribute the 1 half. So it just looks like the sum and difference in numbers, which was what the direction said to do. So I've got 2 plus 1 half log of 7 base 5 plus 1 half log of m base 5 minus 3 log of m base 5. Okay, well, now that was a difficult problem. Just practicing using the properties of logs. All right, you're going to go the other way around now. You're going to write each of these as a single logarithm, and you should actually be able to simplify 5 after you do that. So go ahead and try these by putting the video on pause. Okay, let's do the first one. So we've got, well, I could take these exponents, the numbers in front of the logs and put them as exponents. So this will be the log of x cubed. I made a mistake here. I forgot to put the base. So let's say the base was 4 on both of these. Sorry. Minus, and I've got the log base 4 of 5 to the 1 half. And remember what 5 to the 1 half is. That's just the square root of 5. So, let's see, move this down a little. All right, now I have a subtraction of logs, so you can write that as a quotient. So I've got the log base 4, the numerator will be x cubed, and the denominator will be 5 to the 1 half, or square root of 5. Okay, you can leave the answer like that, or if you want, you could put parentheses around it, so it does get confused with this base of 4. All right, let's go on to this next one. Okay. Well, I have a minus. This thing's going to go in the denominator eventually, and this is a plus, so it's going to go in some numerator, right? The positives will go in the numerator. So, but I first have to deal with this 2 out in front of the log, so that is going to be the exponent on 6. So let's begin with that. This will give me a log base 3 of 6 squared minus the log base 3 of 8 plus the log base 3 of 2. And 6 squared is 36. So I have the log base 3 of 36 minus the log base 3 of 8 plus the log base 3 of 2. All right, now, I'm subtracting here, so that is the log base 3 of 36 over 8. So I could begin with that, 36 over 8. Some people might do this in one step. I'll do that next. But for now, I'll just go left to right. That's what we have so far. Now, we could reduce that now. I'm going to wait and do that at the next step so that I have log base 3. Now, I have a sum, so I multiply these two. So I basically have 36 over 8 times 2, which I'm going to write as times 2 over 1. And I'm just going to do a little canceling here. I end up with 36 over 4, which is 9, right? So I get, whoops, a little bit too far here, log base 3 of 9. Ha! And what's that? 3 to the what power is 9? 2. I like that problem. It's kind of cool. Okay, so let's look at it again. This was the beginning. And we went all the way down to 2. Now, this step right here could have been skipped. You could have gone directly to this step. Anything with the plus signs in front, those go in the numerator. So the 36 and the 2 would go in the numerator. And the 8, that was minus, that would end up in the denominator. So there is one step you could have written a little bit differently than me. Okay, that's it.